World Secretariat and volunteer system has facilitated dispersal of financial assistance directly to the bank accounts of the beneficiaries without leakages. My government has also announced the welfare calendar for the year 2021-22, enabling advanced planning for delivery of all schemes, thereby exhaustively covering all eligible beneficiaries. Education. My government envisions to develop global competencies among the youth through access quality education. My government has supported 44.5 lakh mothers under Jagan Anna Amma Bodhi to send their children to schools, and so far 13,022 crores is spent under this scheme. Through Jagan Anna Vidya Kanuka, my government has distributed teaching learning materials to 47 lakh students. Telugu English dictionary as a part of the student's kit is being provided to promote English fluency in the students. Under Jagan Anna Guru Mudra, 36.88 lakh students have so far been benefited with a total amount of rupees 1600 crores. English is medium of instruction in schools from primary level to help underprivileged students to compete with the students from different sections at national and international levels. English will be medium of instruction for all degree courses from the academic year 2021-22 onwards. We are implementing CBSE syllabus in schools from the next academic year to improve the standards of education. Under Jagan Anna Vidya Divana, my government is fully reimbursing tuition fees. The cumulative disbursement under the scheme works out to rupees 4,879.30 crores. This year, under Jagan Anna Vasati Divana, rupees 1,049 crores is credited into the accounts of mothers of 10.89 lakh students. So far, rupees 2,269.93 crore has been spent under the scheme. Under Manavadi Nedu initiative, school infrastructure is being revamped. 15,717 schools out of the total 44,512 schools have been taken up for revamping under phase 1 with a financial outlay of rupees 3,948.11 crores. Put together, an amount of rupees 25,714 crore has been spent so far under various schemes relating to education sector, nearly benefiting 1.60 crore students. Health and nutrition. Through Dr. YSR Aarogyashri, my government is providing universal health coverage free of cost for all as an important priority. The scheme covers about 1.44 crore BPL families, nearly 95% of the state's population. Under Dr. YSR Arogya Asara, a maximum of rupees 5,000 per month at the rate of 225 per day is provided to patients for post-surgery care. The 108 ambulance and 104 mobile medical units are revamped under NADU NEDU programs. My government is also planning to establish 16 medical colleges in addition to the existing 11 medical colleges in the state. Dr. YSR Kanti Belugu is being implemented to reduce avoidable blindness from 1% to 0.3% in 6 pages. My government has introduced YS Sampurna Poshan Plus scheme, under which supplementary nutrition is provided through Anganwadi centers with an annual budget of rupees 1,863 crores. All the 55,607 Anganwadi centers are now YSR pre-primary schools. English is medium of instruction for PP1, PP2, and pre-first classes in play-way method in YSR pre-primary schools. Agriculture sector. A resilient farming sector is mainstay of the state's economy. The government is leaving no stone unturned to make agriculture more viable and profitable. Under the YSR Raitu Bharasa PM Kishan, since 2019-20, 52.38 lakh farmers families were benefited with a total amount of rupees 17,030 crores. My government is implementing YSR free crop insurance scheme to protect the farmers against crop loss. So far, extending financial assistance of rupees 1,968 crores to 15.67 lakh farmers. Under YSR Sunabhedi Pant Runalu scheme, so far rupees 1,105 crores has been incurred, benefiting 58.96 lakh farmers. My government has established 10,778 Raitu Bharasa Kendras, one at every village, as well as the e-crop booking facility, 9 hours of the pre-electricity during time at a cost of rupees 7,200 crores. My government is encouraging horticulture, livestock and fishery sector as growth engines. Milk collection centers are being set up in the arbitrage in partnership with Amul, and dairy farmers are getting rupees 5 to 15 as additional income per liter through Amul interface. The YSR Matsakara Bharosa stands unique in the country for extending relief to fishermen during the lean period. Like never before, my government has extended assistance of rupees 68,000.31 crores to farmers under various schemes. Farmers' incomes are being protected by ensuring MSP for paddy under the decentralized paddy procurement scheme, with 1,696 centers and electronic payment to farmers with 48 hours. Andhra Pradesh is the first state to provide home delivery of essential commodities to all the ration card holders through 9,260 mobile units. Under YSR Jalkala, 2 lakh pre-bore wells are planned to be drilled in 4 years, benefiting more than 3 lakh farmers. To prevent distress, my government is providing rupees 7 lakh as support to family of farmers who have committed suicide. Housing and social safety nets. Housing is one of the top priority of my government. Under Pedala Ndariki Ilu, 28.81 lakh houses, site pattas distributed to all the eligible beneficiaries in the name of women so far, and to construct 30.9 lakh individual houses in two phases. 15.60 lakh houses are being taken up under phase 1 with a project cost of ₹28,084.9 crores at a unit cost of ₹1.80 lakh and are named as YSR Jagannanna colonies. For the first time in the country, all types of pensions worth ₹1,487 crores are being delivered to about 61.73 lakh persons on the first day of every month at the doorsteps of the beneficiaries under YSR Pension Kanuka without any discrimination of caste, creed and political affiliation. So far, an amount of ₹32,469 crores is spent for the scheme. My government is implementing various schemes for families engaged in the traditional occupations.